Okay, we're gonna. Someone sent me a. Well, first of all, I saw this picture, which I thought was pretty cool. I posted it on my Facebook. I might add it to the website. I've said this before. I think horses get a better life when they're needed than when they're just a hobby. And right now, the horse world is owned by a lot of people who think they're just a hobby and they're a part-time gig. And I think a large part of that is keeping horses at barns. If you've got a pet that you really care for, a dog or cat, you don't keep it at a shelter and then just go visit it once a day and feed it. And that's what a lot of people do who get horses, because they don't have their horses on their own land, so they have to keep it at a boarding facility. And, you know, that interferes with good care of a horse. You don't see it daily. You don't see it all the time. You're not out there. It interferes with the bonding. It interferes with the trust. It interferes with who else is handling it. It interferes with what's done to your horse when you're not there. It interferes to your anxiety when you go there. So if you needed a horse and you needed it for travel, you'd probably have it at your house and you'd use it every day and you would depend on it and you wouldn't want it to go lame, and you would keep his feet in better condition and you would take care of it better, because if it went down or got sick or ill, it would interfere with your ability to survive, versus now it just interferes with your ability to have fun or go to a show. So anyway, I just want to put this picture in the background so I don't put this other video up. What I'm going to talk about here is a well, before I do that, I wanted to discuss another thing that hell, now I can't think of what I was going to. Oh, a trainer trick. A friend of mine told me this story of what this trainer did to this woman, and I was just like, you know what? It's funny, but it's sad that there's so many gullible people out there. And you know, I'm going to get some hate mail because women are going to say that we're not gullible, but women tend to be more gullible because they're emotional. If you appeal to their emotional side, they're going to believe you, and they tend to be a little bit easier to take advantage of. And you can get mad at me for saying that, but that's my belief. Whatever. It is what it is. I mean, car dealerships have been doing it for years. Mechanics have been taking care advantage of women. There's plenty of other examples out there where people take advantage of women. So I'm not condoning. I'm not saying it right. I'm just saying it happens. So anyway, this is another horse trainer. Okay, a guy who a lady has a pony, and she went out and you know, she got this pony, and it was a pulling pony, and it was trained to pull, and you know, she loved it, and she was gonna have it pull her in a little cart, and she went out and bought this cart, and of course, 6 months, a year later, she figures out that this horse is a lot of work. She doesn't know it's not as easy as she thought, and she can't catch the horse, and the stupid horse can't pull the cart, and she obviously got ripped off when she bought it, so she wants to sell the horse, the little pony, and the little cart. And so a guy kind of sees this, and he, you know, the cart and the horse, he thinks he can sell it, so he goes, I'll give you $200 to have her hands. Well, you know, $200 may not be, she may be out some money, but at least now she doesn't have to feed it, she doesn't have to take care of it, she doesn't have to pay board, she don't have to worry about where it's at, she doesn't have to pay vet bills. So for her to get $200, it's probably a good deal, so she just gives it to this guy. She doesn't care what he's going to do. Oh, Rick, she loved the pony. No, she didn't. Most of these women out here running around buying all this pink crap saying they love their horse. They don't love their horse. They love the idea of owning a horse. But I digress. All right, let me get. So this guy buys this pony and this cart for $200. Now, what does he do? He changes the horse's name to Fluffy, and he puts it for sale. But he notices when he has his horse that he can't catch it either. Hence the name horse trainer and not horseman. If he was a horseman, he would be able to catch the horse. Because he's just a trainer, he doesn't know how to catch a horse. So what does he do? He does what most people do that don't know what they're doing. He locks the horse up in a pen. Other people will lock him up in stalls or won't let him out in pasture or come up with 101 reasons on why they can't let the horse loose because they can't catch it because of their inability, so the horse has to suffer and be locked up. Well, this guy's no different. He's just a shyster horse trainer that's going to take advantage of the first dumb woman that comes along. And unfortunately, in the horse world, that's a pretty short wait. So he puts his horse up, $20. All right. Oh. I'm just thinking someone's going, you said all women are dumb in the horse world. I didn't say that. that. Shut up. Get off my channel if you're just looking for something to complain about. All right. So this guy puts the horse for sale. $1,500. Pretty little fluffy pony named Fluffy. Can pull a cart. Comes when you call it. Now, the horse, I just told you he couldn't catch a horse. So how's he going to advertise it comes when you call it? Because while he's waiting for a buyer, every time he feeds the horse, he whistles. So when a horse hears the whistle, he knows that he's going to get food. So guess what? The horse comes. That's kind of like these people to say, I've trained my horse to come. Every time I go to pasture, he comes running to me, Rick. So I know what I'm doing. You don't know shit. Okay, your horse is coming because you're going to bring him in, give him grain, and give him food, and he wants it. When the pasture is lush, and there's plenty of food, and you go out there, and he doesn't come in, you're like, why won't my horse come in? He don't love me. That's because you're an idiot. Okay, the horse comes because he knows he's going to get food. A horse comes when he knows there's something in it. Unless you have a good understanding of a horse and can make your horse come, even when you're not going to give him food, it is whether or not you really have a relationship or understanding of a horse. But anyway, so this guy whistles. Again, an easy trainer trick. To the unknowing stupid guy that comes out there and is going to believe this guy. I'll say guy. He whistles, the horse comes. Like, wow, this guy must be a horse trainer. He's got this horse coming in to whistle. This must be a good horse. Because he knows that a whistle means to come. This is a really smart horse. Yeah, that's it. No, wait a minute. He's a pony. And ponies love people. And that's why the horse came. Yeah, that's it. So all you dummies who think that those are good answers, you're all dummies. Because the only answer is the horse knows and the horse isn't stupid. It's like, hey, I'll come. I'll play your silly game. You can whistle. You can scratch your butt. You can jump up in the air and click your heels 3 times and say, take me home, and I'll come if you bring food. I don't really care what you do, but when I know you're giving me food, I'm going to come for the food. So that's what this pony did. So he comes. So here comes Grandma. Oh, Rick, why are you picking on Grandma? Because Grandma wants to spoil her grandchild. And because she loves her grandchild, she's going to get him a pony. She's not just going to get him a pony. She's going to get him a special pony named Fluffy that pulls a cart and comes when you whistle. So she goes out, sees his horse trainer, this horse shyster, this horse trickster. And he's going to be all nice and tell her Fluffy and what a great horse he is. And so Grandma comes out there and says, I saw your pony Fluffy. I want to see it. He goes, hey. And the horse comes and the lady's like, wow, that is the best trained horse ever. Oh, my God, that horse just came when you whistled. That's amazing. Yeah, okay. She doesn't know the horse is thinking, dude, you just whistled normally. You give me food. Why the hell ain't you giving me food? She don't understand that. She can't read a horse. She can't read when a horse comes. He's looking for the food and acting strange. She doesn't know any of that because she don't know shit. Because she's out to buy her granddaughter, Fluffy. So she buys this horse for $1,500. This is why the horse world is such a shyster turnover. This is why horses get such bad homes. This is why women that want to tell me how great horses have it now because women take care of them and love them more, and that's why horses are so much better off than when the mean men had them and they actually rode them, used them, gave them a job, and took care of them. But now every shelter in the world that's run by a woman is full of horses, and there's full of abandoned horses, and neglected horses are on the rise, and all these women, if you read the paper, every time you see a group of horses that are neglected, it's from a woman that either runs a rescue or a woman that was collecting horses. Or, if you watch the Buck movie, it's from a woman that has a stud that didn't get oxygen when it was a baby, so that's why it attacks people. All this crazy stuff just goes right into point on this grandma buying this horse. She buys it. She pays $1,500. This shady, unethical, not anywhere near a horseman who just wants to use horses to make them money. And there's millions of people out there like that, male and female, that just use horses to make money. This guy's no different. He just rips off people. It's dangerous. He puts horses in bad situations. He put people in bad situation. He can't even catch a horse. He don't know if this horse is going to kill, bite, or kick a kid. And he's selling it as Fluffy that comes when you call it, and it's a great horse, and it pulls a cart. And he makes $1,300 from having a horse maybe 2 weeks from feeding it. So that's a good turnover for him. Not a good turnover for Grandma, and not a good turnover for Grandma's granddaughter. But a good turnover for him. So he sells the horse $1,500. She leaves. What a great horse. This is the part I love. A week later, Grandma can't catch her horse. She let the horse loose at her 40-acre pasture thinking when I whistle, the horse will come, and she ain't seen the horse in a week. Now, who suffers from that? The horse. You can't feed him. You can't catch him. You can't check him for injuries. You can't do his feet. You can't give him worming. You can't do nothing. But because you're too stupid and you want to go out there on emotion and love and, oh, look at the pretty fluffy pony and this guy's a horse trainer, I'll just give him my $1,500 because I'm an idiot. And then I'll get mad at Rick when he calls her an idiot because he's picking on women. Whatever. Okay, this horse is out here for a week. So what's this lady's answer? She calls the stupid trainer that sold it to her, that took advantage of her, and leaves him messages. Hey, you know, this horse is supposed to come when you whistle, and I whistled and it won't come, and I've had other people come and whistle because I thought maybe he only knew your whistle, so I had people doing different whistles to see if maybe the horse knew your whistle and he might think that it was you that whistling, and he still won't come. So I'm wondering, please, Mr. Nice Horse Guy that sold me Pretty Fluffy, would you mind coming out to my farm and whistling so I can catch my horse? Oh my God, are you kidding me? This lady still hasn't got it. She still doesn't have a clue. Oh, it just amazes me, the ignorance when you get a horse involved. And who suffers? The horse, kids, people being trained by these people, people selling, people running barns, people who say they're barn master, people who have all these ribbons on their wall that say they're horsemen and they understand a horse. All that crap does nothing but take advantage of the stupid. So my channel and my website is about educating you so nobody can take advantage of you. I'm trying to help you so you don't get taken advantage of, and I still get so damn much hate mail from women saying, you just like to pick on women, you get that. I'm trying to help you, dummy. If you can't get that, get off my channel and go buy Fluffy and stand out in your pasture and whistle. Otherwise, shut up, I don't want to hear it. For the people that want to learn, hopefully they can see past all this and go, you know what? That's a very good point. I need to be a better steward of the horse. I need to make sure I know what I'm doing before I get into horses, before I jump into something. I need to do my homework. I need to study. I need to understand. I need to know if a guy's ripping me off or lying to me. I can't do that if I don't know nothing. I can't do that if I go out there trusting somebody because he has a pink halter and he's painted pink flowers on his trailer because he's sensitive. He's a sensitive natural horseman because he has pink flowers on his trailer. The ignorance out there amazes me. Anyway, so here's what we're going to do here. There's a video here that a girl gets kicked in the head. And a lot of people are going to say, I'm picking on women again. Yeah, this is the stupid horse. This horse doesn't like women, okay? It's the horse that doesn't like women. So here's the video. It's going to go through here, and I'm going to talk and kind of explain some things. I'm going to mute it so you guys can't hear it, because all you hear in the background is these girls talking, one, a foreign language. I don't know what it is. It's not English. I don't understand it. But they're giggling and laughing and thinking this is cute. And this is cute. Maybe it'll play. Maybe I'll leave it on there so you can hear a little bit in the background. Okay, so look at a pretty horse. Oh, he's running with a red. Look, it's white. Oh, it's just like Black Beauty, but white. Okay, see the horse bucking and bowing? See that curling of the head? See that jumping? Look at those ears. This horse is playing, and I've done this, and people ask me if you should play with your horse, and I say, sure you can. And I do this with Buddy a lot, and he will buck and curl. And he is treating me like a herd. He's acting like a horse. But notice she's reaching, giving this horse food. This horse wants food every time he jumps. So she's using food reward. Now, bam. She just got kicked in the head. Okay, so we're going to go back here and just look at that one part again. Oh, I'll go a little farther. Notice her feet come completely off ground. This horse is turning, he's playing, but every time she's running, she's at his shoulder. Watch what happens when she gets by his back. She's out. He probably got her in the jaw. He probably got her, I don't know where he got her. But the point is, this horse did nothing wrong. He wasn't mean. He wasn't trying to hurt her. He wasn't trying to kill her. All the unknowing idiots out there will see this and say, that horse should be put down. That horse is dangerous. They'll say, oh, that girl shouldn't have been playing. She should have been supervised. They're going to come up with 101 reasons on why this shouldn't happen. The only reason this happened is because of what the person did. The kid got too close. I say kid. I don't know how old she is. She looks maybe 18, 19. She could be 20, 21. But she's out there playing with her horse, having fun. She's not doing anything wrong. What she doesn't realize is when this horse kicks out earlier in the video, she doesn't realize that he's doing this playing and he's not being mean. He's stretching his back. As he comes across her, you notice she's staying at that shoulder and he's stopping for food. When she gets kicked, she gets by his butt. See him current? See him bucking? See that kick? Buddy does that. That's playing. Horses do that to each other all the time. And if they accidentally kick each other, it doesn't hurt. It's not a big deal because it's a horse kicking a horse. Kind of like if I was swinging my hands and I accidentally punched you or pushed you. It may hurt a little bit, but it wouldn't kill you. When a horse accidentally kicks a human, it can kill him. So she's having fun, she's feeding her horse, the horse is bucking, she gets by the back feet here. The horse gets excited, boom. That horse did not do anything wrong. That horse did not mean to do that. That horse did not want to do that. That horse was not trying to hurt, kill, or maim her. That was a simple kick out that horses do to other horses all the time. There's an old horse saying, if you don't want to get kicked, always keep a quarter inch between you and a horse's hoof. Now, had this girl followed that rule, she would not have been kicked. Because when he kicked out, she would have still had a quarter of an inch. She failed to keep that quarter of an inch. Well, Rick, you can't always keep the quarter. The point is, you need to realize when and if a horse kicks, you're either going to get kicked or you're not going to get kicked. I walk between Buddy's legs. I crawl between his legs. I grab his back feet. He could kick me 1,000 times a day if he wanted to. He doesn't. Why? Because a lot of reasons. One is he's used to it. He's in a mode to where it's routine. He knows what to expect. I'm not surprising him. There's all kind of reasons on why he isn't kicking me. But if I do something wrong, if I let him, in one of my round pinning videos where I have Buddy and him playing, Buddy and Mr. T kick each other about 20 times. And everybody thinks it's cute and laughing, and I think it's cute because they're playing and they're teaching each other lessons. If one of those kicks connect with me, I'm screwed. So when I'm in a round pen, when two horses are kicking and playing, it is my responsibility not to get kicked. It is not the horse's responsibility not to kick me. Now, I don't want my horse kicking at me intentionally. I don't want him kicking at me telling me to stop. I don't want him kicking at me, pinning his ears, telling me to go away or that I can't do something. Then I'm going to get involved. But if I put myself in a situation like this girl did where a horse is playing and having fun and is kicking out and doing horsey things and I don't know enough to stay out of the way of that hoof, then when I get kicked, there is no one to blame but me. Rick, you're being mean to that girl. She didn't do anything. That horse just kicked her. Yeah, he kicked her because she was running by his back feet and she was in a position to get kicked. He kicked out before and didn't kick her. Why didn't she get kicked before? Because she wasn't at his back feet. It's all up to you. And I, a lot of people tell me, you're always ranting. You always go off. I try to get you to see the big picture. There's so much more going on than what you see. That's why people say, I rode as a kid. No, you didn't. You sat on a horse as a kid. Well, I jumped and I got ribbons. So you walked around arena and you jumped on a horse that was trained by someone else and you got to ride it and got a ribbon because everyone else either was worse than you or they had to give ribbons to everybody. But whatever the reason, I don't care how many ribbons you got, it doesn't make you invincible. It doesn't make you good. I don't care how many horses you've owned. I don't care what you've done. I don't want to hear all this degrees. And now I had this one lady the other day. I was at a buddy of mine's house. I was working on his feet, his horse's feet, and she came over. And she was going to vet school, and she was going to be a vet. And she was teaching all these people. She wouldn't shut the hell up for a minute, wanting to tell everybody every part of a horse and how you don't ride and don't move and telling everybody not to walk by the back of the horse. Before she got there, I had kids walking around grabbing on a horse's tail. Once she got there, everyone around there was scared, and nobody would go around the back feet. Well, guess what? The horses picked up on this. Pretty soon the horses were threatening people because people were scared to go around the back feet. Why? Because this know-it-all vet going to school, gonna be, wanna be, was, been around horse whole life, started scaring people, and pretty soon the horses figured out, why are all these people? It was at a party, there was a bunch of people, and the horses were doing fine till she came over and started educating everybody. Had to tell everybody what she knows. Had to explain to everybody how knowledgeable she was, and she ended up making all the horses, and eventually the horse ended up kicking, and kicking another horse next to it, because she's out there, she's like, oh, this horse is, I don't know what's wrong with this horse, I don't know why it kicked. I didn't say anything, I just wanted to go, I know why it kicked, because you're a dummy and you won't shut the hell up. You think you know more than you know, and you're running your mouth instead of using your body to communicate. You don't understand a horse. You may know where his fetlock is, and where this bone and the hip bone connects to the ankle bone. You may know all that, but you don't understand a horse. And I've said this before, if somebody's a farrier, it doesn't make him a horseman. If somebody's a vet, it doesn't make him a horseman. More often than not, the odds are they are not a horseman. You can tell in 10 seconds when somebody's around a horse that they know what they're doing. And it doesn't take long, and hopefully if you've been watching enough of my videos and I've talked about this enough, you're able to now use that critical eye, and you can tell in a split second when you see somebody walking up being scared, approaching a horse with the face, trying to stick their hand in the eyes, grabbing a lead rope at the chin, being flinchy, not going by the back, staying away from the tail, don't make any quick moves, it squares the horse, blah, 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 blah. Those are all the cues that the person is an idiot and doesn't know what they're doing around horses. The person who's quiet, who doesn't say anything, who talks to the horse with their body, who moves in, knows the drive line, who knows how to give release, who understands the horse to make the horse come into him instead of pushing the horse away. Those are the things that you go, this person has it figured out. Okay? Hopefully that helps. Got a little long, 20 minutes here, but that was a pretty good little video, I thought. And hopefully everybody that understands horses and knows my videos will not blame that horse. That horse did nothing wrong. If you notice, after the horse kicked her, it kind of ran off and just kept doing its jump. And as far as it was concerned, it was about ready to turn around and say, where's my cookie? What happened? Why is my owner laying on the ground? I've kicked other horses like that, and all they've done is kick me. I've kicked other horses like that, and they've moved away. Why is this crazy owner laying on the ground now? He doesn't know she's knocked out. He doesn't know he possibly could have gave her a concussion. He could have killed her. He could have broke his neck. He doesn't know any of that because he's just a horse, and that's all he knows how to be. And anything he does is being a horse. And people who don't understand will label that negative, mean. He tried to kill her. He's aggressive. He should be put down. He's dangerous. You should never do that. Lock him up. He's going to hurt another. And the big snowball just grows and groans. And next thing you know, you got a horse that was deprived of oxygen. And the next thing is a star on a buck movie. Hope that helps. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys wherever you're at.